Pretpostavljam da znate tko je ovo. Garfield. Kako ćeš na engleskom jeziku izreći rečenicu Garfield je danas sretan? Garfield is happy today. Ali jučer Garfield nije bio sretan. Jučer je bio tužan. But yesterday he was sad. When? Kada? Kada je on sretan, a kada je bio tužan? Today, to jest danas, je sretan, ali yesterday, to jest jučer, je bio tužan. Danas, today, je sadašnjost. Yesterday, jučer, prošlost. Upravo stoga smo u prvoj rečenici rekli Garfield is happy today. Koristili smo present, to jest sadašnjost glagola biti. Am, is ili are. U drugoj rečenici, s obzirom da govorimo u prošlosti, Garfield je bio tužan u prošlosti, koristimo past, to jest prošlost glagola biti. Was. He was sad. Glagol biti u prošlosti, to jest u past simplu, ima dva oblika. To su was ili were. U potvrdnom obliku to će glasiti ovako. U jednini, prvo lice, I was happy. Drugo lice, you were happy. He was happy. She was happy. It was happy. U množini, prvo lice, we were happy. Drugo lice, you were happy. I treće lice, they were happy. Primjećuješ da smo was koristili u prvom i trećem licu jednine, dok smo u svim ostalim licima koristili were. Dakle, kada govoriš o sebi, I, koristit ćeš was, i kada govoriš he, she, it, onda koristiš was. U svim ostalim licima were. Garfield je danas sretan. Garfield is happy today. Ali jučer nije bio sretan. Jučer je bio tužan. But yesterday he was sad. Koristili smo was. S obzirom da je on jučer bio tužan, on nije bio sretan. He wasn't happy. Mječni oblik glagola to be u prošlosti ćeš dobiti tako što ćeš dodati not, dakle was not ili were not. U mječnom obliku to će dakle glasiti ovako. I was not sad. You were not sad. He was not sad. She was not sad. It was not sad. U množini. We were not sad. You were not sad. They were not sad. Was not možeš skratiti kao wasn't, dok were not možeš skratiti kao weren't. Možda će ti ovo biti jasnije ako odgledaš i sljedeći video.